Hi, I'm Shannon Contr, the Natural Farrier, and we're here with Mr. Cruise Control to show you today how to apply a set of Equisocks and nail the horseshoes to them. We're using today, of course, our favorite ground control rubber horseshoes, and we're nailing them to the socks for several different reasons. I like to use the Equisocks in conjunction with the rubber shoes on my horses just because I want to eliminate nail holes being in their feet. I'd like to be as natural as possible while providing support. Mr. Cruise Control has a really excellent story, and another reason why he's going to be wearing rubber shoes instead of completely barefoot, as I want you to read more about him in my case studies. But Mr. Cruise Control was in Practical Horseman at 4 years old, and at six he was retired for being completely lame. He had a small career as a riding instructor horse. He was used in a lesson program to take some kids around, but he couldn't even stay sound for that. And the owner ended up giving him to me, and we did a series of therapies on him, and they're all available in his case studies article, but it's a really interesting history. Now, Mr. Cruise Control is 100% sound now, and after we've applied our Equisocks, he's actually going out on a venting course. So enjoy the video, and we'll be back. Okay, we're ready to choose the size of shoe so that we can go ahead and nail it to the Equisock. Here I've got a size 1, and I'm going to kind of gauge and see how this looks. Generally, the size you nail to the Equisock is going to be the same size that you nail to your horse. This shoe fits nice. There's no overhang of the shoe, but there's a little bit more overhang of the Equisock than I'd like, so that nail track looks like it's going to be going into the foot and not the Equisock, which is not what we want. Now this is a size 2. We have a little bit of heel overhang here. That's absolutely normal. We can go ahead and trim that off with the nippers when we're ready. The Equisock fits well. The nail track is fitting closer to the edge of the hoof, so I think this one's going to be just fine for nailing. What I'm doing here is cutting along the suggested heel track. You can see a groove here in the shoe. You don't have to cut along this groove, but this horse actually happens to have a perfect foot that lines up exactly with the heel track. Now the Equisock, when you nail your shoe to it, nails exactly like hoof wall. There are no special nails, no special techniques at all. The most important thing is making sure that you've picked the correct shoe size for your horse. But other than that, it nails exactly the same. You don't need any special nails or tools. Okay, here we are with our near finished product. We've got the Equisocks and the shoes applied to both feet. I've put 4 nails in each side just because this guy has really big round feet. Generally, I just do 3 on each side. So now that we have the nails in, and I've cut them off with my nippers, but I'm going to come back and cut them one more time just to be sure that everything is nice and flush, just to make sure that there's no excess nail overhang. I like to cut these off as soon as I apply the shoe. I go back and do my other foot, and then I come back and double check and nip these again if they need it, because these shoes will settle to the shape of your horse's foot, so we want to just make sure once the shoe's settled that we don't have any nails that have actually come through any deeper. So we're just going to go ahead and clinch these feet just like they were bare feet without the Equisocks on them. Come here, buddy. And you can see what's nice, too, is that our clinches clinch down into the fabric of the Equisock, that they're not clinching into the hoof wall. So we've got our nails that have gone into the Equisock. We have our clinches that are clinching down into the Equisock. So this hoof wall has not been invaded at all. So what I'm doing with my rasp is I'm filing my shoe at a bevel. So I'm coming down from the top of the shoe out at a little flare. That way I'm just giving my shoe nothing to step to get caught on. But I'm not invading the nail track, so I won't cause shoe failure. I want to to show you one other thing about the back of these shoes you might have a question about. Now you can see that obviously the shoe's nailed onto the front, but the back is still flexible. If your horse were to overreach, and of course we trim off the excess heel so there's nothing to step on, but if your horse were to get this caught in a fence or overreach, you can see how the foot is, the shoe is almost like a flip-flop, that it'll pull, but it snaps back into place. If you were to catch this with a metal shoe, the shoe's going to bend and it's going to rip off. I very rarely have shoe failure due to them being caught on anything or a horse overreaching because it's just flips. The purpose of these shoes, obviously, is we like the flexibility and to allow the hoof capsule to move and for the shock absorber. Okay, here's another thing I'd like to share with you is that I trimmed this shoe before I put it on the horse, but I'm always a little generous at leaving some excess overhang because you can always take more off. You cannot put it back on. So I'm going to show you how to trim off this little bit of extra while it's on the horse. Come here, buddy. So I like to have heel support, and I like to make sure my shoe goes all the way to the back of the foot. I don't want to cut it off so that my heel is short, but we just want to cut off that little bit of overhang. So this is just as easy as if you were trimming a bare foot. You just cut into the shoe and pop it right off. And I like to take my rasp and just clean this up a little bit. Now, if you have a horse with special needs, you'd like to change the brake over, the shoe is as equally easy to file up here. If you needed to quicken this guy's brake over, if you wanted a little bit more slope, you just simply take your rasp and file it down. You can take the nippers and cut this straight across if you need a severe breakover, if you were doing laminitis or founder treatment. But again, if you just wanted it, thank you, sir, to change your breakover slightly, it's very easy to file. Just clean up our heel back here, get rid of any excess overhang. But again, you can cut a lot to modify your heel. But again, remember, do not use your nippers up here because you'll invade this nail trap. But these are just as easy or easier than a metal shoe. Hang on it. Stay back all the way. Stay back. Stay back. Stay back. There, better.